Nezo can't do anything.
Action! Okay. Huh? Hey, wait, guys, this
Ian,
is clap time.
Are you ready? Are we okay, one more clap.
Action.
Oh, we got two claps. I'm done. What is going on, everybody? I'm here with my friends. And this is kind of becoming a habit, like a thing that we do pretty much every month or so. Yeah. You just won MLG Columbus, first event on GOAT. Pat, tell us.
Yeah, I mean, this is my fourth Call of Duty title where I've won the first major tournament, me and TP. But got some great teammates, and I mean, we're just going to continue this train as long as we can.
Yeah, so Mr. X, give us a little rundown of what happened in that last series.
You know, that last series, I mean, TK is a very good team, you know. And we knew we were going to have to win our searches. We really didn't practice too much coming into this event.
I've heard that.
Yeah, and we really just got creative on search. A lot of the problems that we had in Black Ops 2 is we were too predictable on search. We kept doing the same thing every round. We really didn't have any other strats to fall back on. And this event, we did a lot of watching, all of us, and we kind of took pieces of what we saw from everybody else and put it together on the fly. I mean, it worked.
Yeah, arguably, you and TK are the two best S&D teams in the game at the moment. Like, what do you think it was, guys, that kind of pulled you above them?
Basically, we copied what other people did from seeing them play their matches on main stage, side stations, etc. And we just do it better than them, to put it quite simply. We learned a lot from this event, at least I did personally. I'm sure my teammates have as well. So I feel like we only got better playing at this event. We won, we weren't that prepared for it, and high hopes for the future.
Yeah, Krim, you had another awesome event. Do you want to give us your little rundown of how it all went for you?
Well, we showed up. We won a couple matches. We won the tournament. We're going to do some things that I'm not going to say on camera, and then we're going to go home.
Okay, well, I'm down to do those things. Like, I'm ready.
I don't know what they are.
Oh, well, as long as
Krim's into some weird stuff.
Okay.
Man.
Yeah. I've heard. But, Krim, I remember, I think in the last interview we did after G42, you talked about playing in the moment and just staying focused and kind of just like being completely in there when you're playing. And, like, do you want to like expand on that a bit? Because I think it really plays in you guys' favor and like a big part of what you guys do.
Yeah, I think, like, we just know we're going to win. And I mean, that. I know that sounds really cocky, but that's the only way you can really think. If you think like, oh, I don't know if we're gonna win or lose, then like obviously it's better than thinking you're gonna lose, but you gotta think you're gonna win. And I, to be honest, that's like the best advice. I think we all like know in our heads that we can win every single match, and just like that difference between knowing it and thinking it, I think that's why we're so effective at winning tournaments.
Yeah, I mean, do you guys think that Matt has a big role to do with that, like the coaching and keeping you guys focused on what's going on around you?
No, yeah, of course. Since we picked up Matt after Call of Duty Championships, I mean, our team only got better, especially like maturity-wise and responsibility. And I mean, I don't think we could have made a better addition to our squad.
What's your opinion on that?
I agree.
Yeah. Sweet. Clay, like I just mentioned it to you before the start of this interview. You made an absolutely insane play on, it was Freight Blitz, I think. Do you want to give us, like, what happened there?
Well, we were pushing there.
Other than just destroying four kids' careers.
Yeah, well, that is, to put it simply, that's what happened. But we were mainly, we were just pushing them out of their spawn. All my teammates died, and they called out two of them on the skull for me, and so I know that I was using the Vector and I had quite a few bullets in the clip, so I just went in there, killed two, and they said that they're running from their spawn, so I just went ahead and posted up and got the other two.
Yeah, and then you slid in.
And I got the goal too, so four piece and the goal.
Yeah, and so it's hard for me because Blitz, I haven't found that enjoyable the whole of this competition. Then a game like that comes along, and it was awesome to watch. I mean, Teep, I interviewed you earlier, and we kind of agreed that it's not the most exciting game mode, but then something like that happens. Like, how do you see that in your head?
I mean, I think it's a little bit fluky as far as a competitive game type goes, but obviously creates some, you know, stellar results as far as excitement for the fans. So I guess I have to appreciate it for that. I just hoping on CTF.
Yeah, I'd like to see that back, because I think there's like a certain amount of coordination required, and you guys on Black Ops 2, I think that you had like an amazing record in CTF, am I right?
We lost one map. One CTF map, like, ever since we made this squad, so.
Yeah. Alright. Ian, what's your opinion on Ghost and, like, going forward into the next events?
I actually hated it at Machinima, but now, actually, like, after this tournament, I kind of like it. The gunplay and consistency is far better than Black Ops 2, I'd say. But Black Ops 2 had so many more features. I don't know, it's a really great game, but it needs some
It needs some adjustments.
And refinement.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think I spoke to Tina again this weekend, and hey. Yeah, and I think the main thing that needs to be changed is
Tina.
Away! It's just kind of like tweaking. It's less about the game, because the game, the hit registration is all good, but maybe the playlist and kind of like those minor things that are really important competitive.
Yeah, I mean, like game modes and a couple extra settings and features, I mean, that we would really be at a good college.
Really, yeah, really good at that, yeah.
No, yeah. It's just, I mean, there's small things, and if they're done, we're going to have a good year for sure.
Yeah, I mean, would you agree with that, Clay?
Yeah, there's a couple points. I mean, in Black Ops 2, it took about a month and a half for Hardpoint to even be somewhat playable. Like, they had to fix a lot of the spawns, they had to nerf, tweak a lot of the guns, and so with this tournament being so close to the game release, you know, 2 weeks basically, it didn't give it enough time to flush itself out really. And here at the tournament, we kind of saw some of the spawns come into effect, and we kind of saw what really just needs to be changed, and those minor improvements will make this game a lot better.
Sweet. So, like, again, don't want to take up too much of you guys' time, but a couple of final last points. Highlights of the tournament.
I'm gonna go with Clay's four-piece. That was
Clay's four-piece.
I started screaming like a maniac.
Yeah, that was really sweet. Yeah. I like that.
Sweet. And yeah, I guess how are you guys feeling for the next event?
I mean, we're feeling good. I mean, it's the same time every time we go to an event. I mean, we all know we're gonna go in with high hopes, and we never let ourselves down. But I mean, this team we have now is just unbeatable in every aspect of that word. But another highlight of the tournament, I think, was Mr. X's reaction to the 35-5 on Prey Blitz.
What happened there?
I don't know. I just kind of started laughing, and then we watched it again, and I like slapped Teep in the shoulder, and Teep started laughing. And then I did some like weird hand gesture then, and I don't even know what it was. Like, it was like, what the hell are those people doing? Like, and I like flicked them off of my hand, and we were just laughing pretty hard. We watched it in the room last night about 10 times, like, straight.
If I can find that, I'm gonna possibly.
Oh, it needs to be like jipped. It needs to be jipped. It's like a 12.
As complexity sweep skyline. As complexity. As complex. As complex. As complex. As complex. As complex. As complex. As complexity.
Second span. I also love when Ian talks trash to the other team, because it's like the most. It's like the weirdest things ever. Yeah.
Ian, any opinion on that?
I agree. I think that's kind of like my style, to be honest.
I think the one of the.
I don't say like normal things. I guess you could say that.
Do you want to give us an example, possibly?
An example? Well, I was screaming Shaboy.
Shaboy?
Yeah, that's what Fwiz says.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you to Fwiz for letting us stay at Machinima and be really annoying for 8 days.
The stream is pretty cool.
He gave us pizza too. Pizza Hut, Power for Hour, cheese pillows. What else did we say?
Monday. Shout out to Pizza Hut.
Yeah, it's pretty much it. Yeah, shout out to Pizza Hut.
Sure. Sweet. All right, guys. Well, yeah, thanks so much for your time. Again, Complexity guys have helped me out since day one at Gfinity, and I always appreciate the time you guys give me. So any shout outs to sponsors and anything like that?
I want to give a shout out to you.
Yeah, that's a good shout out.
I appreciate that.
You've come from the steps of
right,
Gfinity.
Remember Gfinity 1?
Yeah.
Gfinity 1, he was like outside, and he's like, hey, did you see that funny video we made? And we were like, dude, we saw that. Yeah. It was like hilarious. Did an interview with G1. G2, they let you inside the building.
They did.
And look at this, now you're at MLG Columbus.
I know.
You're on the come up.
In the States, man.
I am. And it wouldn't be half as quick if it wasn't for you guys. So.
No problem. Really, but also a big shout out to Complexity for putting us out here. Their sponsors as well, Soundblaster, Newegg, and the rest of the crew. Big thanks to those guys for supporting us and all we do.
And the friends and family.
Oh, yeah, and the friends and family that all came out and supported me. Thanks to those guys, too.
Sweet.
Boom.
Any from you guys or just sponsors?
When's the next tournament? No shout out.
December 14th.
I have no friends in real life.
Shout out to Krim.
My team doesn't even like me.
Sweet. All right, guys. Thanks so much for your time. Okay. Hope you all enjoyed that.
Peace.